Ever since Spectre and Meltdown were discovered, researchers have been looking for other bugs that expose speculative data that computer designers thought no one could see. Their latest discovery, L1 terminal fault, is particularly dangerous because cybercriminals can use it to steal information across multi-tenant cloud environments. Software patches have been created to minimize the threat, but companies need to take action based on their specific situation. So how does L1 terminal fault work? Think of your computer as a hotel. A guest checks in at the front desk and is given a room number. When the guest dines at the hotel restaurant, she can give her name and room number to the waiter and charge the meal to her hotel tab. But if she knows the name and room number of another guest, she can charge her meal to that person's account instead. When guests check out, the hotel will figure out the problem, but by then it's too late. Cybercriminals can exploit a similar situation on Intel servers to steal data. In the L1 data cache of Intel processors, each byte of memory has both a physical and virtual address. The operating system tracks these using special maps called page tables. Now, processors spend a lot of time walking through page tables, so to speed things up, they speculatively search the L1 data cache for matches before they confirm that the page table entry is valid. If it isn't, the processor will signal a terminal fault to the operating system and throw away the speculative data. But before the fault occurs, there's a small window of time when malicious users can figure out the value of the data. Then they can trick the operating system into loading sensitive information into the cache and steal it. Even worse, cybercriminals can use this flaw to exploit a multi-tenant cloud environment. Here, hypervisors use page tables to map physical server resources to virtual machines. They can also use extended page tables to share management with those virtual machines. The problem is, a cybercriminal running a virtual machine on that server can create a malicious extended page table and trick the hypervisor into revealing secrets from other virtual machines. It's a bit like a hotel guest tricking an employee to let her into someone else's room. To mitigate L1 terminal fault in bare metal environments, a software patch has been developed to prevent tricking the operating system into creating vulnerable page table entries. This patch has very little performance impact. In virtualized environments, a patch has been developed to force the hypervisor to flush the L1 data cache when switching between virtual machines so there are no secrets to steal. Unfortunately, companies running untrusted virtual machines may have to shut off Intel processor hyperthreading. This can significantly reduce server performance. Because not every company will have to take this drastic step, operating system vendors are not turning hyperthreading off by default. Cloud operators must take action based on their individual use cases. To decide what your company should do, visit your vendor's website for more information. Researchers and technology companies will keep looking for new security bugs. And when they find them, we must come together to fix the problems that affect us all.